Fellowship of the Ring. I mean, the church.
Fellowship of the church, I knew that.
Fellowship of the church. We would hear people in the Christian community say, let's have some extended fellowship after church. But what does it really mean when someone says fellowship? That's what we're going to find out in today's episode. So stay tuned. Hello, people in the world. I'm Hannah of Hope and Future Bible Devotions, aiming to help the young and the young at heart overcome life with the help of the Bible. So if you're new here, then welcome. In today's episode, we are going to be talking about fellowship. Fellowship comes from the Greek word koinonia, which means sharing in common or communion. There is actually no equivalent English word to the Greek word koinonia. This word is just so rich that it's so hard to find one exact English word that talks about koinonia. What we are going to do in today's episode is to talk about the essence of the word. So let's dive in. It actually appears for the very first time in Acts 2 verse 42. That says, "And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in prayers." With that said, fellowship is not just that warm feeling that you feel when you're around a lot of people, and it's also not just about food. What? It's not? But what about breakfast? Well, you've already had it. I've had one yet. What about second breakfast? No, it's not just about food. Though food can be a great tool to have a great time together, fellowship should be characterized by the church. And when we say church, we're not just talking about the building. We're actually talking about the body of believers in God. With that, let's break down Acts 2 verse 42. First, it says, "They continued steadfastly." What does steadfast mean? It actually means firmly loyal, unswerving, or unchanging. With that, it says that the apostles were firm in what they were doing. Let's continue. In the apostles' doctrine. The apostles' doctrine actually talks about the word of God, and that includes who God is, who Jesus is, and what the power of the Holy Spirit is as well. One of the pastors that I really look up to is Pastor Chuck Smith. His way of teaching the Bible is verse by verse and sometimes even word by word. The advantage of this type of Bible study is that we really get to dig into the word and what the passage really says. And with that, it helps us understand even more what the Lord is trying to tell us through the Bible. Now let's go on to fellowship. Fellowship means an intimate sharing of oneself to one another. Koinonia also means contribution. In Romans 15:26, there are actually churches mentioned there that contributed to help the poor in Jerusalem. And that is what the fellowship of believers are also called to do.
Before we continue, if you've been gaining value from this video, then go ahead and give it a thumbs up so that it can be shared to more people in the YouTube community.
There are actually a few things that we can do in the fellowship. One is to look after each other. It says in Ecclesiastes 4 verses 9 to 10, "Two are better than one because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him who is alone and when he falls and has not another to lift him up." We are to lift each other up. I remember a time when I was really down. I was telling the group of women in the Facebook group that I was okay. The Lord is in control. I was saying those things. But there were two women in that group that were thinking that I was not okay. They just went to my house and they came just to comfort me. That was a precious moment for me. I didn't ask for them to come, but they willingly came to just be there to hug me and to listen to my cries. And that is one of the things that I love about the fellowship. My friends were there to lift me up. I hope you have that too. Next is to practice love toward one another. In John 13 verses 34 to 35, it says, "A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You also are to love one another. By this, all people will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." People in the church are not perfect. We have our pet peeves, we have flaws, we get on each other's nerves sometimes. But you know, one thing that we have in common, it's the knowledge that we are all saved by grace. Jesus knows our flaws, and yet he chooses to love us. And if Jesus can love us, then all the more we can love each other. The next thing about fellowship is that we are able to learn about God through each other. Especially when you are new in the faith, you need someone to guide you. And it really helps you know more and get the correct guidance from someone who is more mature in the faith. Peter said in his letter in 1 Peter chapter 5 that the elders are to take care of the flock. Likewise, the younger should listen to the elders. But all of this is to be done in humility. So if you're not mentored or discipled yet by anyone, then maybe it's time for you to find one. The next part of Acts 2 verse 42 is breaking of the bread. Now this is the fun part, right? It's eating! It's second breakfast! In a Filipino community church, one thing that is very common is that there is a lot of food. You won't just have food in the party, you're also gonna have food that you can take home. During the days of the apostles, the breaking of the bread was actually very symbolic. They shared from the same bread, they shared juice from the same bottle, but of course they had their own cups. And it symbolized oneness in the spirit. As we said earlier, koinonia also means communion, where we break the bread, and we remember what Christ did for us on the cross. We share oneness in spirit. If you go on in Acts 2, verse 46 says, "And day by day, attending the temple together and breaking bread in their homes, they received their food with glad and generous hearts." There is joy and fellowship in breaking of the bread. Then we have prayers. Besides studying the word, praying is important to the gathering of believers. In fact, it is a priority for the church to do. Before any activity or event, we have to pray first because we are not merely working or striving with our own efforts. We need God's guidance. It's a spiritual battle and prayer is our weapon. In Ephesians 6 verses 13 to 20, it actually talks about the whole armor of God. You have the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, shoes for your feet, shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, praying at all times in the Spirit with all prayer and supplication. So remember, the fellowship of the church is not just being together, it's doing God's will together. And what is God's will? That is to know God as a person and draw close to Him and then love and serve Him with our whole heart. So with that, I'm going now. I bid you with a very fond farewell.